they're being herded out of the country like cattle, the dispossessed. The UN Refugee Agency said 2,500 people were crammed onto these trains heading for Macedonia. On Wednesday, another 5,000 were forcibly expelled by train. Everyone interviewed told similar stories of masked men in uniforms knocking on doors and telling people to leave or be killed.
Kanë qenë me gruan, me fëmi, me tre vlazën, me dy motrat, kemi qenë 22 antar të familjes. Edhe I kemi lënë shtëpia të shkret në lagjën e spitalit. Po po thëmë këmë qenë, unë këmë qenë, këmë qenë. Gruja më ka bëjtë për dore, pëse unë jam konë, si punëtori arsimit, jam konë, jam konë shumë, shumë I mërzitur, këmë mendu që së këtë jemi më në Kosovë.
Shëndjenja, mas në të vetë në hyrë prapë që të rëmë?
Po kjo është, kjo një knasi, I përshef këtë popullë. Na përshkojmë sot për festë.
When I traveled in this train, I was 15 years old. I was a teenager. I was just with my parents. For another person, for another member in our family, we don't know anything about them, because the police officers divided us from them, and we feel so angry and we feel so disappointed. We don't know about their faith. They were alive or they were killed. And we don't know for a long time about them. We stayed in this train when we were in Ferizaj. The police officer burned down a school near the station, the railway station, and we saw the police officers, and we saw the house or a big house was burned. And
20 years after.
20 years after, I feel in another way. We feel so happy. We feel happy, and we, or the emotions are different, because we hope for a future, a better future. We hope for a better future.
Of the darkest days at the end of World War II, with refugees streaming in all directions. Shocked and exhausted, the refugees arrived in Macedonia, safe at last. But they're in need of food, clothing, housing, and medical attention.
Twenty years ago, we were expelled from Pristina, my father, my mom, and my brother. We went to the train station. Unfortunately, it was full of people. My mom was sick. We had to push her through the window in the train. We left the road. We reached Honi Elezit. It was raining. Full of people. We were walking through this rail way. We were told that there are minefields. We reached at the Bllace mud. We stayed for 13 hours full of people. This is an extraordinary memory. I'm so happy that today we are free. I hope this will never happen in Europe and all over the world. And I hope that the future will not repeat this history.